We were fire evacuated
Monday night.
And
at midnight.
At midnight.
And the power went out. Power went out. So then I got a phone call after the power went out. So I answered the phone, and it was level three. So they said, just grab all your stuff and get.
The air quality is just non-existent. You can't breathe up there. It
burns your throat, burns your eyes, and can't stay very long.
No, you can't stay
very long. Can't stay very long at all.
We've lived here since 1981. 81. A lot of our friends and neighbors have lost way more than, our home is still there. And we were told that there's a lot of, we know everybody, and there's a lot of people that we do know that have lost their homes and businesses. The businesses are gone. A lot of them in Gates are just gone.
So we kept an eye on the fire, went to bed, and then about 5:30 got up, and we could smell smoke in the house. And he said, you know, we got to get out of here. We had no power. Actually, we had no power shortly after we got home on Monday. And we have a garage door that is dependent on electricity, so he would have had to manually open that. And when he went out to open it, the fire was at our neighbor's fence and was headed toward our shed. And we knew we didn't have time to get out, so we just took the dogs and ran to the river. And so we came out and sat on the bank, and we were there from 5:30 in the morning till we were rescued at 11:30 at night. It looks like Dante's Inferno. I left my wallet in the house, so I have no wallet, but my husband had his wallet. And my iPhone, when I got in the river, I fell, and my iPhone was in my purse, and so I don't have an iPhone that works. Essentially, we lost everything, except our lives and our dogs, which is the most important thing, and hopefully our cat. We'll go back and see if she made it.
They just knocked on the door and said, get out now. And it came in so fast. We had no idea, because that day it was clear. And it just came in within a couple hours. And the sky turned red and orange, and then the ball of fire. And our neighbors knocked on the door and said, get out now, everybody get out now. My sister, she lives right in Gates. Her house was gone, clear down to the fire station's gone. Friends of ours' house across the road was gone. The mayor's house is gone. Wow. And this is just what my husband saw driving around. So we're hoping our home's still there.
We got here probably about 11 o'clock last night. And the car, kind of the last 3 miles, the alternator was going out and our lights went out, and we just had a hard time getting around up here, but we made it. Oh my goodness, the sky was bright red. I mean, you could tell the fire was coming in, and on the other side, it was turning red and orange, and at 3:30 in the afternoon, it was like it was 8:30 at night. It was scary. And ash was coming down, like when Mount St. Helens blew up. All the ash came down like that. It was coming down that way, but it was all black. I kept getting ashes in my eyes, in my nose, in my mouth. It was pretty intense. Everybody evacuated way before we were told to. A lot of people were scared because of the red, all the smoke and the ash, and everybody just left, and then there was like 4 cars left when we left. Oh, I've only seen it on TV, and then I never thought it would ever happen to me, and it's very scary.
And of course, we live where there's big cedar trees and big Doug firs, so anyway, all this stuff started coming down, crashing and banging in the woods. Then I could start seeing a glow to the east, and I thought, that's pretty close. So after I started hearing the fire trucks coming through Gates there, I decided about 11 o'clock that I think things are getting a little bit too windy, and the fire seemed to be pretty close. So I said, we're not going to wait for somebody to come in here and tell us that we have to evacuate. I'm pretty sure that's going to happen.
Do you know what happened to your place?
Do I know what happened? Yeah, it burned to the ground.